Good morning students, welcome in video lecture of electronic devices and circuits. We are discussing unit number 2, MOSFET and its DC analysis. In previous lecture, under this point, that means under this topic, common MOSFET configuration, in that under this topic we discussed the DC analysis of a MOSFET. In that we gone through the entire analysis of the all parameters, ID, that means drain current, for that drain current, whatever the required gate voltage related to that we are discussed one, and the related VGS voltage for that threshold voltage, these all parameters we discussed one, and by considering that point of a view, we are again calculated some sort of the equation with the having the small signal equivalent circuits, right? And for that we are implemented the common source configuration, and by using that circuit we are discussed this particular point. Now under the same topic, that means common MOSFET configuration, under that topic we are going to discuss the next point as the MOSFET as a switch. Here we are going to see how the MOSFET can be utilized as the switch. Now see here, in this slide we are going to discuss how the MOSFET it is used as the switch. Now normally it is said that MOSFETs are a good electronic switch for the controlling loads as well as the some CMOS digital circuits, because they operate in between the cutoff and saturation region. See, as the feature of this particular MOSFET, it is operating under in two regions, you can say that, or in between two regions, as the cutoff region as well as the another is the saturation region. And due to that, it is said that MOSFETs are very good electronic switches for controlling the loads as well as the CMOS digital. In that particular circuit, they can be considered one as a low voltage, that means for the operation of a low as well as a high input or output voltage, not input, output voltage, that means low as and high. We will see that thing also. Now for this operation, I just here displayed one figure which showing that how the that MOSFET it is operated as a switch, right? Here the second point, that particular, you can see that figure in the same diagram. See here, this particular thing, it is equivalent of this particular, you can see that figure which is acting as the switch. Now here see, entire RL is considered, and the entire this particular, whatever this we are considering, VIN and MOSFETs, that device it is considered as the one of the switch. So this is the thing. Now here, as we know that the N channel enhanced MOSFET operated, or it operates using the positive input gate voltage, right? Positive input gate voltage. See, I am saying that positive input gate voltage, though I am not written here gate name, because whenever you are applying the that particular positive voltage to the gate voltage, then only that MOSFET it is, you can say that turn on, and that particular current it is flowing from the drain to source. See, so here it is said that it operates using the positive input voltage and has an extremely high input resistance, making it possible to interface with the nearly any logic gate or driver capable of producing a positive output. See here, as the gate it is operated with the positive voltage, and having, as you know that that MOSFET it is having the that silicon oxide layer, due to that it is having the high input impedance, or its resistance is very high, right? And due to this, it is making with the nearly very you can see that possible to interface with the other, you can see the device, right? and due to that consideration you can produce here capable output voltage, right, or output signal. That is the here I want to say here. Now as I explained here in the previous slide, that due to the very high input resistance, we can safely parallelly together connect different more MOSFETs until we achieve the current handling capability that we required in that circuit. See here what I want to see here. Due to the having the high input resistance, we can safely parallelly together many different MOSFETs until we achieve the current handling capability of for that particular circuit which is required in that, right? And while connecting together various MOSFET in a parallel, it may enable us to switching high current or high voltage loads during doing so becomes expensive and impractical in both component and circuit board space, right? So this is here what I want to say here. Due to its high impedance, input impedance or input resistance, here it is possible to connect many MOSFETs together so that we can achieve the that current handling capability of that particular circuitry. It can be possible, but whenever we are considering here various MOSFETs in a parallel to be enable the switching current, high switching currents or high voltage, for this purpose it is very expensive and impractical to connect all these on that circuit boards. And to overcome this problem, power filled transistors or power FETs were developed. So here it is having the good advantage, but another thing is that we can't connect that much n number of MOSFETs together in that particular circuit. And here we can enable the, or you can say that we can connect the power filled field effect transistor or power FET is to it is developed one to overcome this blur problem. Now see here, in enhanced mode MOSFET, now this particular part just I want to say you how we can implement this one, but here actually we are going to discuss now. In enhanced mode MOSFET, as a switch it requires a positive gate voltage to turn on and zero voltage to turn off, making them easily understood how the switch can be, you can say that gates. That means how these particular MOSFETs can be used as the switch in the you can see that in to interface, easily interface with the logic gates. See here what I want to say here. See MOSFETs, e-MOSFETs, which requires the positive voltage to switch from on, right, and zero volts to switch off, right? And due to this we can easily interface in a logic gates. So this is the thing. Now see here how the, once again I just shown here, if suppose you want to make this particular switch on, that means you have to apply some sort of the this gate voltage, right? And due to this gate voltage it will be, you can see that, turn in on position, so that this particular whatever the VDD you are applied with, whatever the voltage it is there, due to that voltage this current ID it will flow through this particular. When it will flow here, this switch is closed one, that means the transistor on one. That is the I want to say here. Now to understand how exactly it will be work one, right, we have to consider the VI characteristics of this particular MOSFET. So here to the operation of enhanced MOSFET or e-MOSFET can be best described using the VI characteristics curve, right? And for that, this curve it is shown in the following figure. Now here when input voltage Vin to the gate of the transistor is zero, conducts virtually no current, and the output voltage Vout is the equal to the supply voltage VDD, so MOSFET is in a off operating within its cutoff. That means unless and until you are not applying the gate voltage or Vin voltage, that gate voltage which cannot or it will not reach up to the threshold voltage, that particular transistor it is in a off position. That means in position, right? That I want to say here, right? Now, next, the minimum on-state gate voltage required to ensure that MOSFET remains in a on when carrying the selected drain current can be determined from the VI transfer curve. See here, whenever you want to turn on that particular thing, that at the gate voltage, and whenever you are applied that gate voltage, that means it crosses that particular voltage, that means there is a flow in the ID current, and due to that ID current, this particular transistor, it is made in a on position. This is your on position. It remains in on position unless and until that gate current it is applied one and it is increased one, right? That is the thing. Now, next is the drain current ID, it increases to its maximum value due to the reduction in the channel resistance, and ID becomes constant value depends it independence on that particular, right? It independent on that particular VDD, and is depends only on the V voltage, applied VGS voltage, right? Therefore, the transistor behaves closed switch, but the channel on resistance does not reduce full to zero due to the its on RDS value, but get very small. That means here, even though that ID current it is flowing one, the channel resistance it is not totally, you can see that zero. It is having sense of the on resistance value, right? That is the thing here. And here, whatever the ID is there, it is totally independent on that particular VDD, and it only depends on the VGS. In which manner you are applying the VGS, depending on that ID, it is flowing one, right? Now, likewise, when VN is low or reduced to zero, the MOSFET Q point, it moves from the point A to B along the load line. See here, the in previous, if suppose whatever the Q point here initially it is shown here, because in this point, this particular gate voltage, it is very high one, and due to that, this in initial stage that it current it is ID it is flowing one. But whenever the VGS it is less one, it is 0-1, at that time this A point it comes to B point, and in this position this MOSFET it is get, you can say that turn off, right? The channel resistance is again become very high, so the point so the transistor acts like the open circuit and no current flows through the channel, so the gate voltage of the MOSFET toggles between the values high and low in these two situations, right? The MOSFET bear like a single pole, single throw, solid state switch, single pole, single throw, like that it is one of the switch, it is acting like that particular operation, right? This is the thing. Now, this action which is defined one, it is having the two kinds of actions. One is the cutoff region. Here, the operating condition of the transistors are zero input voltage. See here, two conditions I said. One is the cutoff region. Here, transistors operating condition of this transistor is a zero input voltage. And due to this zero input voltage, there is a current which is ID, it is also 0-1, right? And output voltage VDS, it is nearly equal to VDD. Therefore, enhancement type of a MOSFET conductive channel is closed and the device is switched on. Whatever the channel is there, it is totally closed one, it is having the totally closed one, and due to their high resistance, there is no any input, there is no any current it is flowing through the drain region. So due to this position, this device it is acting as the switched off position. Now, here this condition it is shown one, whenever the switch on off position is there, that means switch is open is there, right? At that time VN it is very low and the that is nearly zero, that's why this switch is it is open one, transistor is not. This parameter will shown the exactly how the acting out it is considered. Now, next, is the saturation region. In the saturation or this another operating position, the transistor will be biased so that maximum output amount of a gate voltage is applied to device, which results the channel resistance RDS. It is almost, that means it is become a small, or it is, you can say that decreasing one, and this RDS is also called as the on position resistance, and due to this maximum drain current it is flowing through the MOSFET switch. Therefore, for the enhancement type MOSFET, the conductive channel is open and the device is in a switched on position. Due to that, that current it is flowing through the that channel. So this kind of a thing it is shown here. Here the VDD, whatever it is applied one, and due to this particular biasing signal, that transistor it is on position, and here the switch it is closed one. Why? Because this particular entire region it is now it is having the current, it is flowed through this particular thing, and due to this current, this transistor it is acting as the on device. And for this on device, here VDD is, VDS is equal to zero. Ideally it is saturation, but it is zero, and previous it is showing one. So 1 to 0, 0 to 1, like that it is operating. These are the two operating, you can see that condition it is considered one. And likewise the transistor, it is acting as the switch for high as well as the low input output voltage. Whenever the transistor it is gate voltage it is you can see that applied one, then at that time due to that position transistor it is switched on, and whenever the gate voltage it is zero, at that time transistor it is switched off. And for this switched off condition, the this situation is called as the cutoff region of the transistor. And whenever it is on one, the this position on position it is called as the saturation position, and due to that transistor it is toggling between the high and low voltage. That's why it is called as the MOSFET, it is called as the switch MOSFET, it is acting as the switch. Getting my point? This is the you can see that all about the MOSFET, how we can act, connect it as the switch. Students, this is all about one, and be in touch and be safe and study well. Thank you one.